Hey guys, it's Swanski here, and today we're back in Elite Dangerous, and I am finally going to upgrade to the Asp. This has been a long time coming. I've been working towards this ship for quite a while, but I never quite managed to get there. But anyway, we're here now, so let's go into the shipyard. And I'm actually at Jameson Memorial, if I can even speak, which is the what you might have heard as the Founder's World, which that means I get a bit of a discount, basically. So we scroll across to the Asp, I actually went past it. The Asp normally costs around, I think, 6.6 million credits, and here it's 5, well, say 6 million credits, so it's a bit cheaper here. So I'll buy that, and my exchange on the Cobra is over 2.5 million credits, and so what I'll probably do is I'll buy the Cobra back after having the Asp and making a bit of money with that so that I'm not left, you know, just with one ship. But anyway, so let's buy this. Done. This should be interesting. So now we just gotta wait for the sail to process and everything. It'll load in the cockpit, and then we can actually see what it looks like. It does take a while. Oh, there we go. Okay, we are in. It's got a pretty good sized glass canopy. I actually can't look around the whole thing because TrackIR keeps glitching out. It doesn't like me looking up. I'm actually looking above the sensor. But that's an interesting canopy. That means you'll be able to see a lot in combat. That's pretty cool. Interesting as well, it doesn't seem to be a two-seater cockpit. It's actually a single-seater. You can see down the, out of the bottom as well. That's pretty cool. That's nice. Alright, so let's have a look at the outfitting, and then I'll actually take the ship and do a bit of... I'll probably do some combat with it. But let's open up the outfitting. So I've got 676,000 credits left over. How much is the rebuy cost at the moment? 250. Yeah, I can deal with that. That's not too bad. Okay, let's open up our outfitting. And I'll go in here so we can get a look at it. There you go. You can't really see much of it, unfortunately. I really can't wait until I have decent third-person views in the game. I don't have a free paint job for the Asp, and I think the decals are just the skulls. Yeah, I might leave that off this one. Alright, so, what have we got? We've got 4 utility mounts, we have 4 small hardpoints and 2 medium hardpoints, and then we go down here, most of the hardware looks like size 5, with a bit of size 4, and then we've got, what's that? That's actually a size 6 slot. With a 32 capacity cargo rack, so I should be able to double the size of that cargo rack, put it up to 64. Got a size 5 shield, and that's a size 3 compartment, and 2 more size 3 compartments, so that's 3 size 3 compartments, and then 2 size 2s down there. That's pretty useful. That's a lot of room for activities. So let's load up this, put some weapons in here. How am I going to do this? Okay, so I'll do the mediums first. I think I'll put multi-cannons in the mediums. Preferably gimbaled multi-cannons. You can see I've got a huge range of choices here. This is because, again, I'm on the Founder's World, which means that I think pretty much every component is available for purchase, which is pretty cool. So hopefully I'll have enough credits to load this out at least somewhat decently. So we'll do gimbaled multi-cannons for those, and then I'll do gimbaled pulse lasers for the rest. Not pulse lasers, beam lasers. See if I can find them. There they are, 67,000. Okay, the beam lasers are done, so that's our weapons set up. I'll also purchase a chaff launcher, because I've found that to be very useful. And we'll have plenty of room for other stuff as well. I'd probably get a kill warrant scanner too. I'll just go with the cheapest one. Has the shortest range, but it also uses less power. And I'll keep an eye on my money, I don't have much left. So I might leave that for now as it is. The rest of this stuff, I'd like to upgrade most of it to at least D level, which means it weighs less. Probably not much point at the moment, because like I said, I don't want to spend too many credits. We might even be able to go and do a bit of combat with it like this. I might put a shield cell bank in just to be on the safe side, though. After thinking about it for a bit, I've decided not to go with the shield cell banks, just because I think I'm probably stretching the insurance costs as it is right now. Let's actually have a look at that. Okay, I can still afford the rebuy cost, but not by much, so I'm actually going to leave that as it is. So what else have we got? Let me actually get back into my outfitting, just so I can show you the stats. So I'm using most of my power, but definitely not all of it, so there is room for a bit more, even with this kind of crappy loadout, in terms of the internal compartments. Cargo capacity, I've got 38 tons, and that I'll be easily able to upgrade that once I've got a bit more money. Fuel, 32 tons, and yep, that's all good. So jump range isn't particularly great at the moment. It's only 12.7 completely empty, or 11.7 full, basically. It's enough to get you around, but you'd really want it to be a bit more. But that's good enough for the time being. So let's head to the nav beacon. Can I see that while I'm docked? I don't think I can. It doesn't matter. All right, let's launch out of here. And this ship launches off medium pads as well, the same as the Lakon Type 6. Which means it's good because you can still go to outposts and everything. It's the large platforms that outposts don't have. So just wait for this to release us. But yeah, so this ship is basically, think of it as an upgrade to the Cobra, effectively.
Ship
So
released. Engines engaged.
it's a multi-role ship really. It's often considered to be just an exploration ship. Oh, listen to that engine. And it's fairly sluggish at the moment, but starting to respond a bit. Yeah, so it's generally considered an exploration ship, and it is good for that. But it can do a lot more. I mean, this thing can carry more cargo than a Type 6. It's got more weapons than a Cobra. You know, so if you fit it out the right way, it could be really good at basically anything. So we've got 253 meters per second, just normally. And then with a bit of boost, once it has enough energy, there we go. It'll get up to 344 meters per second. It's pretty cool. But anyway, let's go to the nav beacon. There it is. Good, so that engine. I really should have set my fire groups while I was in the station. Didn't really think of that. Doesn't really matter though. There we go. All set up. And I'm actually kind of nervous now about flying around with all these pilots around. It didn't bother me at all with my Cobra because, I mean, it didn't really matter. The Cobra's rebuy cost was like, I don't know, 80 to 100,000 credits and I had millions. So that wasn't an issue if I died. But now, dying once, it won't wipe me, but it'll come close, basically. But the other good thing is that being in an ASP, it's probably a little bit less of a target. It's obviously less of a target than a Type 6 would be, but even less than a Cobra as well. So I think somebody would have to be really looking for a fight to come after an ASP. At least that's my way of thinking. Although it would depend what ship they're in as well. Somebody in a Python probably won't care too much. But this is also a busy system as well, so once I jump out of here eventually and go back to a less populated area, I won't have to worry about that at all, I don't think. At least not as much. But we're getting pretty close to the nav beacon now, and I am interested in seeing how this does in combat. So I'm expecting that it won't be the most maneuverable thing, and that's not a bad thing by itself. The Cobra's not highly maneuverable either, but I think the firepower is what I'll be relying on more than, you know, outturning my opponents or anything like that. I'm going in here way too fast. Probably going to overshoot this pretty badly. Yep. Really badly. Let's get this nice open cockpit so we can look up, see where everything is. Alright, nearly there. Come on. There we go. What was that? Okay. Doesn't look like I've got any players in here at the moment. Ooh, that engine. That engine, though. He's clean.
Scan
So I'll do my normal thing of flying around here and looking for wanted targets, basically. Okay, so this hauler here has a bounty. I don't think he's going to last very long. I'm actually going a bit too fast at the moment. But I'll stop right behind. It looks like he's actually stopped, or at least going very slowly. But let's open up with the beams first. And that's his shield's gone. And that's my reactor empty. Well, not reactor, but energy. Completely drained. It didn't take long. But once I've got a better power distributor, that will last a bit longer. But anyway, he's dead. Hello, Python. Oh, that hauler went down pretty fast, but I mean, you kind of expect it to. This engine sounds a little bit silly, if I'm honest. That's going to take a bit of getting used to, I think. Oh, what just jumped in there? Is that another Python? Yes, it is. What have we here? Do you have a bounty? No, you do not. That's a shame. Oh, I almost feel bad about this one. Let's just use the beam lasers and see how long they last against this shieldless eagle. Once I get a good shot on him. That's only two of them. Three? Well, that didn't go as well as I'd hoped. I've shamed my family. Oh, he's dead. Long enough. It's a really good combo though, multi cannons and beam lasers. I mean, this is basically exactly the same combination as I was running on my Cobra, except that I've got two extra beam lasers. Obviously the fire grouping, like the, or not grouping, but the weapons pattern is a bit different. So those are the beams there, and those are the multi cannons there, which picked a really bad time to reload. But it's probably actually better than the Cobra, because the spread, they're nowhere near as far apart, they're actually a lot closer together. Which means you're more likely to have all of your weapons on target. Whereas the Cobra, the beam lasers at least, or the hard points on the bottom of the ship, were fairly wide apart. So you could often be hitting with one but be missing with the other, especially if you were using fixed weapons. Okay, we have an ASP who is wanted, so let's give this a kill warrant scan. See if we can get a bit more credits out of it. But this might be interesting. So it's probably the first challenging ship, at least somewhat challenging, that I'll have come across. I might actually go straight for the power plant as well. Don't know how much use that's going to be, but it can't hurt. So I'll get kind of close to them, and then I will put all my power to the weapons. I might actually just hit the booster. Because, I mean, somebody else is firing as well. It might be system security or something like that. Oh, that's a good enough reason to open fire. And down go the shields, almost. There we go. Open up with the multi-cannons. Multi-cannons just tear the hull apart, and the beam lasers will do a bit as well. Once they're fully recharged up again. Oh, fuck. That was a collision. Not an intentional one, but it was actually caught on the side of the ship, which is interesting. The ship is a bit bigger than I'm used to. There we go. So yeah, the beam lasers aren't really great at taking down the hull, but you can see the power plant is at 10% now. Very nearly dead. Nearly took out, or nearly got friendly fire there. But anyway, he should be dead any second now. And there we go, 31,000 credits. ASP on ASP for violence, it's a terrible thing. But well, we took care of that pretty easily. I mean, to be fair, I don't think they're actually focusing on me in terms of their weapons fire, except for that accidental ramp. But yeah, the ship seems to be handling itself pretty well so far. It's as expected, it's less maneuverable, and I have a feeling this guy will have a bounty on him. Yeah, I thought so. He's doing all the pirate dialogue. But it's not as maneuverable as a Cobra, and definitely not as a Viper, but you wouldn't expect it to be given the size of the ship. The one thing that's annoying me is how quickly the are you actually taking my shields down, you fucker? Little bastard. How embarrassing would that be, being killed by a fucking sidewinder? Oh, you're trying to like demonstrate this ship. Alright, there we go. That was a bit silly. But anyway, like I was saying, not as maneuverable as a Viper, but given the size of the ship, you wouldn't expect it to be particularly maneuverable. And I think I'll need to upgrade the shields, but apart from that, it's handling itself really well. But yeah, you don't really want to be using this, or at least you don't want to be using it with laser weapons on the standard reactor and power distribution system, I don't think. I think I might be better off have going with like 4 multi-cannons and 2 beam lasers or something like that, just to ease the load on the reactor. But it's going pretty well. The only thing I'd kind of would have liked to do is have like a Python or an Anaconda or something jump in here, but they seem to be pretty rare sometimes at the nav beacons, so there's not much I can do about that. But what have I got so far? Wait for that to update. Yeah, say 30,000 credits. I had the other bounties previously from my I had the other bounties before from a bit of stuff with the Cobra. So yeah, it works fine as a combat ship. I think we all know, or we've all heard by now, what a wonderful exploration ship it is, because it can get such a large jump range. And of course, if you load it out correctly, and by correctly I mean by not having any shields, you can carry more cargo than a Lakon Type 6 can. And that's with the Lakon not having shields as well. So it really is a good all-round ship. And I think once I get some upgrades into it, it'll be really good. I mean, realistically, I probably shouldn't have even bought this ship until I had, you know, 4 or 5 million credits left over and I could just throw a ton of money at it. But I just got impatient, if I'm honest. I mean, if I'd waited for it and I could have bought those upgrades straight off the bat, it would be a far superior ship than it is right now. And I just bumped my microphone. But I'm surprised with how good it is already, to be honest. So I expected it to be a lot worse than it was, or than it is. With just a basic loadout. But yeah, so I think I'll end this one here. So this is the Asp, and it's pretty cool. Does this guy have a bounty? No. Yeah, it's pretty cool. And oh my god, that was close. But I think there'll be this will feature a lot more in my future videos, because it's going to take me a hell of a long time to get up to the Clipper or what else is there? The Type 7? I think those are the next big ones to aim at. So yeah, this is going to be my main ship for a while. I'll probably pick up a Viper or something for combat as well, like dedicated combat. But yeah, so expect to see a bit more of this in the future. But until then, I've been Vosko, hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.